Hey everybody, this is iLad, and today I want to show you how to set up a second keyboard, which you may have lying around the house, as a control board for OBS or StreamLabs OBS. You may have heard of a device called the Elgato StreamDeck, and if you're not familiar with it, what it does is it basically is it's kind of a tablet that gives you icons on the screen you can tap to adjust different things with your stream. They're expensive. And I'm gaming on a budget. I'm streaming on a budget. So when I found out that it was actually possible to set up a second keyboard, which I pulled out of storage and didn't have to pay for, as more or less an alternative to an Elgato, I was like, heck yeah, man. So essentially what the purpose of this is, normally if you plug two keyboards into the same computer, Windows reads them as the same keyboard. So you can type on one, you type on the other, and it works the same way, and Windows doesn't seem to know the difference. Included in this installation is a program called LuaMacros that essentially locks out one keyboard, and it lets you choose which keyboard to do that. So that keyboard becomes a macro keyboard where every key, or almost every key, is fully programmable. You can make it do whatever you want to with it. Well, there are a few keys that don't work. I'm going to mention those and explain those a little bit later in the video. But for the most part, if you've got a 108-key keyboard, you've got around 100 or so new hotkeys that you can do stuff with. Meanwhile, your main keyboard still functions normally. So you can still type away, play your games, whatever, on your normal keyboard without having to worry about accidentally overlapping with your hotkeys. So I'm going to link the original video that taught me how to do this in the description below. But one thing that I found when I was setting it up was it was insanely complicated to actually get stuff to work and to set up the hotkeys on the second keyboard. So what I've done is I've kind of reworked it a little bit to add an interface and make it easy for non-coders to set up on their own. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you some of the things that this setup can do. I'm going to show you how to make it work for yourself, and then I'm going to tell you where you can download the files and get everything up and running. So first of all, among the things that it can do is it can change scenes in StreamLabs or OBS or regular OBS. So if I want to, I can drop my face cam. I can pull up, you know, a streaming soon screen. I can pull up a be right back screen, toss in a slideshow to cover up whatever's actually displaying. I can do a soundboard.
Stay a while and listen.
There's a lot of things like that that I can do all by tapping a single key on my keyboard. And if you've used StreamLabs OBS or regular OBS for a long time, you're probably aware of their hotkeys function. You're going to want to go ahead and set up those hotkeys before you start using this software. Because in reality, it all kind of builds on the existing hotkey system in your broadcasting software. This should work for other software as well. It shouldn't be exclusive to StreamLabs OBS or OBS. But I did kind of design it with those two programs in mind. So if you find that some things don't work exactly the way that you expect them to, that'll be why. All right, so before you even get started with my software, you're going to need to download AutoHotKey. Now, this is a really powerful piece of software. Lots of people use it for various purposes. And it's the backbone, really, of this whole keyboard setup. All right, so you want to go ahead and download that, install it, get it running. There's not a lot that you need to actually do as far as prep work. But if you don't have AutoHotKey, you're up the creek. All right, so the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to download the file that contains all the scripts and whatnot that you need to make this work. You're going to go ahead and extract that. Extract. And you can put it in any folder you want. So I'm just going to drop it here. The only catch here is you really need to be sure that everything here stays in the same folder. This is one of the differences between the default installation that I originally started working with and the modified version that I'm talking about today. Everything should be in this folder right here. So the only file that you're going to need to actually work with is obsmacros.ahk. If you've successfully installed AutoHotKeys, you should get some options on your right-click menu that include Run as Administrator. So you're going to want to go ahead and do that. I've never actually been able to get this to work properly if I wasn't running it as an administrator. Of course, I get the Windows dialog that pops up asking me if I'm really sure I want it to make changes to, yeah, whatever. Yes, of course you do. And then on running, you get this little dialog right here. Would you like to start Lua Macros? If you want this to work correctly, you're going to click yes. All right, so that pops this box up. Now, at this point, you want to be really sure that you don't hit anything on your main typing keyboard, because that's going to be a problem for you. Go ahead and hit any key on your macro keyboard. You get a bunch of junk scrolling past your screen. Doesn't matter. Go ahead and minimize that window. You're done with it right now. And at this point, guess what? You're officially set with two separate keyboards that do two separate things. But it kind of leaves you hanging a little bit. What now? How do you set up hotkeys? Well, here's how. There's a couple of preset hotkeys I've already kind of included for you. The first one that you're going to be interested in is Control, Alt, Shift, N. And when you hit that key combination, it pops this little box up on your screen. And it pretty well explains step by step what you need to do. So first it says, press the key on your macro keyboard that you want to bind. So let's say I want to bind my number pad 5 key to bring up the BRB screen in OBS. Yeah, you hear that? Nothing happens. That's totally fine. It says, second, please enter the hotkey description. All right, so I'm going to put BRB screen. Cool. And I'm typing that, of course, with my regular keyboard, my typing keyboard that I haven't done anything to. Please enter the hotkey combination. All right, so that's in OBS, I think I have that set to Alt number pad 5. All right, cool. And I'm going to go ahead and close that. And now at this point, I should be able to bring up the BRB screen just by hitting the number pad 5 key on my macro keyboard. Yeah. Now, full disclosure, occasionally this misfires. It doesn't hit 100% of the time. It's some kind of a timing issue with the way the OBS looks for hotkeys. If you can monitor OBS on a second monitor and keep an eye on it and be sure that it's responding correctly, it's going to save you a lot of heartache. But yeah, that's pretty sweet. All right, I want to set up some more hotkeys, but these hotkeys I want to bind to sounds. So I'm going to hit Control, Alt, Shift, S this time. And it brings up the sound dialog box. All right, so it says press the key on your macro keyboard that you want to bind. I want to bind the Z key to a little sound clip from the original Diablo game. All right, please enter the sound description. Stay a while and listen. Let's see, I'm going to hit pick sound, then add another so that it's going to automatically bring this back up. Pick sound. Da, 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 da. Stay a while and listen. All right, so it goes ahead and pops a new copy of the sound dialog box up on my screen. I'm going to go ahead and add a Pikachu sound effect. Pikachu. Pick sound, then close, because this is going to be the last sound I'm going to add. Oh, and I'm going to bind this to the A key on my macro keyboard. Pick sound, then close. All right, Pikachu. Now, if everything worked correctly,
pick a B.
The A key does that, and the Z key should play Deckard Cain.
Stay a while and listen.
Sweet. All right, so what if I decide that I didn't actually want the A key bound to Pikachu's little sound clip? What if I want it to be a clip of Diablo's voice instead? I'm going to go ahead and get my sound dialog back up, Control Alt Shift S. I'm going to hit the A key, which I had previously bound to Pikachu.
Pikachu. Pikachu.
Sound description, Diablo Taunt. pick sound, then close. Not even death. Yeah, cool. All right. I'm going to hit the A key.
Not even death can save you from me.
Basically, it got rid of the Pikachu code and it overwrote it with Diablo code. So if you ever want to edit a hotkey, it's totally easy to do that. You're just going to pretend it's already blank and you're just going to override it with whatever the new instructions are. All right, so I'm going to walk you through the process one more time. I'm going to add a thank you screen to OBS. So I'm going to Control Alt Shift N for new hotkey. Please enter the hotkey description. Oh, I'm going to bind this to numberpad 1, by the way. All right. Please enter the hotkey description. This is going to be thanks for watching. Please enter the hotkey combination. This is going to be, I believe I had it set to Alt numberpad 1. I'm going to add another one after this. Let's do a soon screen as well. So I'm going to hit, for this, I'm going to use numberpad 7. Please enter the hotkey description. Starting soon. Whatever, please enter the hotkey combination, Alt numberpad 7. And close. All right, now, just without doing anything on my typing keyboard, just by hitting the numberpad 1 on the macro keyboard. Cool. OBS has some other issues with reading hotkeys, even when the script is not involved. So before you really get going on this, you want to test. Make sure that everything works properly just on the normal hotkey combinations on your normal typing keyboard before you start messing around with this script. There are a few keys that you can't use at all. I'll throw them up on the screen here. I've never been able to get any kind of good results with Caps Lock, Shift, Control, the Windows key, the menu key. It's a little box about two keys to the right of your spacebar. I have gotten to work, but it's more trouble than it's worth. The function key, if your keyboard has one, is probably not going to work for you. Print screen, scroll lock, and pause break on your macro keyboard are not going to work. Pretty much everything else you can use. Escape key is already bound to it. What escape does is reloads the hotkey script. If you ever, for any reason, if it's kind of glitching out on you and you just want to set it fresh, get rid of some dialog boxes, whatever, hit escape on your macro keyboard and it should reload the hotkey script. Those are pretty much the macro keyboard hotkeys that won't work. On your typing keyboard, Control Shift Alt S and Control Shift Alt N are both spoken for by the sound and new hotkey dialog boxes respectively, so you can't use those. And I did bind your pause break key on your normal keyboard to open up the Lua macros program that I have up on the screen here. So if for any reason you have accidentally closed Lua macros, no, don't save changes. Just hit the pause break key on your normal typing keyboard and it gives you the little dialog to reload it. And then of course, again, just like before, you see this screen, you hit a key on your macro keyboard and that'll be the keyboard it locks out. And the last thing that I have to show you is down here in the system tray. Got a lot of stuff going on, of course, but right here. If you right-click on that icon, you've got some controls. You can exit the script. You can edit the script, which I don't recommend if you don't know what you're doing. You can reload it if it's kind of glitching out, but the escape key should be doing that for you anyway. That's escape on your macro keyboard. But yeah, that's pretty much how you can turn a spare keyboard into the equivalent of, what is it, $150 Stream Deck from Elgato. again, I don't have $150 lying around, so it is really nice to be able to take this piece of junk out of the basement and set it up as a control panel, basically, for anything I want OBS or StreamLabs OBS to do. I've been really pleased with it. It has worked really well for me. I'm not a professional programmer, so use at your own risk. But it's been pretty reliable for me, so I'm pretty happy with it. Hopefully it'll be as useful to you as it is to me. Please, if so, or if you have any questions, don't hesitate to leave a comment down under the video, and I will try to help you with anything I can that doesn't extend to actual coding advice. If you're digging into the actual code, keep backups of everything, check out the AutoHotKey and LuaMacros websites that are linked below. I'm really not the person to come to for advice on coding. Anyway, let me know how it goes. Check back on my channel. I'm going to be, maybe if there's a lot of interest, adding more features to it, updating it. As a new version comes out, you'll be able to see, you know, news about that here on this channel. Or you can check the website where I'm offering the download link, and that'll always have the most recent updates available. So thank you guys so much for watching. Good luck using it. And take care. Bye-bye.